Leute auf dialysis sorgen, mission of front, this in a row for deadly occlusion and repair. What about dialysis access? The goals and the indication of dialysis therapy, initiation of dialysis, and the specific algorithm of how to start either early or late dialysis, and at the end will deal with conclusion. When hemodialysis became a maintenance treatment for end-stage renal disease in the early 1960s, dialysis devices necessitated 10 to 12 hour sessions applied mostly twice a week to allow a minimal control of uremia. With more efficient dialyzer and the arteriovenous distillate, with high blood flow became available, the length of the session could be reduced and a thrice weekly short dialysis, 4 hours per session, became standard. What about in Egypt? In Egypt, 1998, Professor Wahid Saeed had convinced the Ministry of Health about the need for the thrice weekly hemodialysis to end-stage renal disease patients to increase their survival and improve their quality of life, including their ability to walk. What about chronic kidney disease? It's presented usually as non-specific clinical presentation. Diabetes and hypertension constitute about 50%. Other causes, including glomerulonephritis, polycystic kidney disease, and obstructive uropathy, characterized by decreased renal mass, increased parenchymal heterogeneity, and poor cortical medullary differentiation. As regards the definition of chronic kidney disease, EDU guidelines 2012 mentioned that kidney abnormality is a kidney disease for more than 3 months with implication for health, with marker kidney damage, including either urinary sediment or albuminuria, more than 30 milligrams, that's good for our urine, or electrolyte abnormalities. Or any abnormalities detected by histology, renal histology, or any structural abnormalities detected by imaging, or histopathic transplantation, or glomerular tissue less than 60 ml per minute. This includes the definition for chronic kidney disease. What about the risk? As regards risk for chronic kidney disease, we combine staging. Depend on glomerular filtration rate and the albuminuria. And green color in this chart represent a little less. So stages above 60 ml per minute, there is mild risk. Yellow color represent risk. Orange color represent high risk, while red color represent very high risk. Again, EDU guidelines recommend that chronic kidney disease is classified based on the cause, glomerular filtration rate category, and the albuminuria category. As regards the cause, may be due to systemic disease affects the kidney, like diabetes, autoimmune disease, systemic infection, some sort of tumor interstitial disease, like systemic infection, autoimmune sarcoidosis, others like vascular disease, atherosclerosis, hypertension, cystic disease, like polycystic kidney disease, or the primary lesion will be in the kidney itself, like primary focal or crescentic process of glomerulonephritis, or anti-associated renal limited vasculitis, or renal dyskinesia. What about complication of chronic kidney disease? Is a multiple and multiple system infection, including extracellular volume overload, segment hypertension, alcoholic acidosis, dry disturbance, hyperkalemia, hypocalcemia, hypercholesterolemia, chloroides, precarditis, anemia, bleeding biases, and GIP manifestation, which is usually common for practice, anorexia, nausea, consequently weight loss, and evidence of malnutrition, CNS, neuropathy, and psychological affection with depression. Is there any role for early nephrological referral? Yes, of course. electrological interferon and pre-dialysis care are essential to prolong patient survival. Studies suggest increased all-cause mortality in patients referred late. It often occurs late due to both patient and physician biases. Why so early? Chronic kidney disease can progress at different rates. Reversible causes like vasculitis, management of comorbidities like anemia, bone mineral metabolism, hypertension, and malnutrition. And there is role for discussion of dialysis, early creation of dialysis access, and decreased need for urgent dialysis, which usually accompanied with high mortality. Dialysis access we have permigas, arterial venous fistula, and synthetic graft, and take of proteinuria dialysis. As a GAP P2 guidelines 2006, preparation for patient for permanent hemodialysis, when the patient reaches stage 4, he should refer, and IV referral can be made for the appropriate modality and placement of permanent dialysis access. In patient with chronic kidney disease stage 4 and 5, forearm upper arm bands suitable for placement of vascular access should not be used for belly puncture, placement intravenous, intravenous line caster or subperineal caster to avoid subperineal venous stenosis, and the peripheral inserted central caster line. We have to spare this for the next test. Patient should have a function permanent access at the initiation of dialysis therapy. Better to have fistula should be placed at least 6 months before the anticipated start of hemodialysis treatment. This timing allows for access evaluation and additional time for revision to ensure a working fistula is available at the initiation of the dialysis therapy. As regards the graft, an arterial venous graft should be in most cases be placed at least 3 to 6 weeks before the anticipated start of hemodialysis therapy. As regards proteinuria dialysis caster, okay, also about 2 weeks before to avoid leakage. As regards selection and the placement of hemodialysis access, the order of preference for placement of hemodialysis access in patients with kidney failure or choose hemodialysis as their initial mode of kidney renal replacement therapy should be in the descending order of preference: peripheral fistula, acceptable arterial venous graft, avoid of possible long-term caster. As regards the fistula, we prefer rest radiocephalic and the egg brachiocephalic or transposed brachial basilic vein. Acceptable arterial venous graft, a forearm loop graft preferable to straight configuration, upper arm graft or chest wall. And this is the different modalities of dialysis access. Avoid the possible long-term caster. Short-term caster should be used for acute dialysis and for limited duration in hospitalized patient. Non-cuffed femoral caster should be used in bed-bound patient only. Long-term caster or dialysis port caster system should be used in conjunction with a plan for a permanent access. Caster capable of rapid flow rates are preferable. Long-term caster should not be placed on the same side as a maturing arterial venous fistula as possible. Special attention should be paid to consideration of avoiding femoral caster access in hemodialysis patient who are current for a future kidney transplantation to avoid iliac acid thrombosis. What about dialysis scenarios? In the hospital, usually we have many indications of dialysis. Either the patient has had a gradual decline in renal function and have a planned dialysis start state, as usual we have in our chronic kidney cases, or have an acute superimposed on chronic renal failure during a course, or have an acute renal failure that progressed to a reversal chronic renal failure, usually more than 3 months, or receive dialysis related to combination of renal failure and end stage heart or liver failure, when dialysis is used primarily as means for fluid management. Goals of dialysis: free of uremic symptoms, to control the volume overload, acid-base and electrolyte disorders, to provide clearance of uremic toxin enough to allow an adequate dietary routine and caloric intake. When residual kidney function fail to maintain all these vital functions, we have a solid argument for starting dialysis therapy. Since an important goal of dialysis is to enhance the quality of life as well as to prolong survival. Initiation of dialysis: the decision to initiate dialysis in a patient with end-stage renal disease involves consideration of subjective and objective parameters by the physician and the patient. The decision to start maintenance dialysis should not be solely based upon serum creatinine or estimated GFR. It has a negative psychological impact on the patient. It's a bad news with important social economic implications. Patient education is the central tenet of optimal initiation of dialysis. When to start dialysis is a subject to be controversial. وهو ده موضوع المحاضرة اللي started بعد dialysis start early start late وإيه فايدة ده وإيه عيب ده. طيب الفيديو 2006 قالت إن العيان اللي هنبدأ معاه dialysis المفروض نعمله preparation، المفروض نوضح له once ما هيبدأ stage 4 احنا المفروض نوضح له إيه الأوبشنز اللي متوفرة له including kidney transplantation renal dialysis, but hemodialysis is in the home or in the center. The patient, family members, and the caregivers also should be educated about treatment choices for kidney failure. Estimation of kidney function is very, very important. We don't have to do serum creatinine, but estimation of glomerular filtration rate should guide decision making regarding dialysis therapy initiation. Glomerular filtration should be estimated by using a validated estimating equation, Cockcroft code or Mendel equation. We can make a measurement of creatinine and urea clearance, not simply by measure of serum creatinine and blood urea nitrogen only. The timing of therapy: when patient reached stage 5, chronic kidney stage disease, what means this major GFR has been at 15 ml per minute. Nephrologist should evaluate the benefit and risk and disadvantage of beginning kidney replacement therapy. Particular care consideration and certain characteristic complication of kidney failure may prompt initiation of therapy before stage 5. نيجي للارجومنت ما بين الايرلي والليت وايه اللي بدافع عن ان احنا نستارت ايرلي. كان في حاجات في الـ early 2000 بيقولوا ان patient initiate dialysis early يعني estimate GFR more than 10 ml per minute. This trend to an early start is based on conventional wisdom regarding the benefit of dialytic clearance, the albumin level and nutritional marker, and the early dialytic therapy is justified to improve nutrition, especially in diabetic, and that waiting until low level of estimated GFR less than 6 ml per minute may be dangerous. وده كان الانسيدنت نيو كيسز في اليونايتد ستيتس من 1996 ل 2008 والدايابيتك والنون دايابيتك وكان في دايما انكريمنت ان هم يستارت دايلس ايرلي وهنا الكيرف ده بيبين ان القصه ان انا استارت ايرلي دايلسز يكون الانفكشن ستيت بعد العام افضل الالبوم يكون عالي ووجد ان الناس اللي بدات دايلسز والالبوم بتاعها لو كان السرفايف بتاعها كان اقل والمورتاليتي كانت اعلى. لغاية لما بدأ دراسات من 2002 لغاية وقتنا الحالي قصة تعديل الهيس ده ملهاش لازمة خالص. وأول دراسة كانت في اليونايتد كينجدوم في جلاسكو اللي هي أقرت إن الاستادي فيز تو سبورت أ بوليسي أوف إيرلي أبريشيشن أوف دايليسيس فور بيشنت ويز انتستيجيان فيلير. أنزل راندومايزد ستادي كانت في نيوزيلاند وأستراليا اللي هي الأيدل ستادي ديزاين برضه الموضوع الإيرلي دايليسيس وكان برضه الليت دايليسيس وكان الكونكلوجن بتاعها ان early initiation of dialysis in a patient with stage 5 chronic kidney disease was not associated with an improvement either in the survival or the clinical outcome. Another study كانت في هارفارد United States في امريكا برضه كانت معموله على عدد كبير جدا من المرضى around 100,000 مريض بداوا معاهم early وحوالي 113 بداوا late. وكان conclusion بتاعهم ان كان late initiation of dialysis is associated with a reduced risk of mortality arguing against aggressive early dialysis initiation based primary systemic GFR. الكابلان ماير survival curve ده برضه موضح ان الناس اللي بدأت late dialysis كان survival rate بتاعها اقل كان اعلى من 0 ل 5 كان هم the best group versus أكثر من 10% كان السبب بتاعهم أقل. يديبوا 2013 dialysis to be initiated when one or more of the following are present symptoms or signs attributed to kidney failure, the astrocytes, acid base, electrolyte abnormalities, pruritus, and ability to control volume control, our blood pressure, our progressive deterioration in nutritional status refractory to the dietary intervention, our cognitive impairment. In conclusion, it can be reasonably stated that timely initiation of dialysis treatment cannot be based merely on numerical data, but should be decided according to the overall clinical tolerance of each individual patient according to his or her advanced stage of uremia. Early dialysis initiation are not upheld by facts and evidence, and that early dialysis initiation does not consistently provide a mortality or morbidity or quality of life benefit unless accompanied by compelling reason for initiating the treatment such as volume overload. Early dialysis initiation using creatinine-based estimated GFR for decision-making may be harmful. Preservation of residual renal function has clear morbidity and mortality benefit. The efficacy of multidisciplinary pre-dialysis patient monitoring and education in conjunction with planned dialysis initiation at glorification rate level 5 to 10 to 9 ml per minute for asymptomatic patient need there's a study. Initiating dialysis at the right time for a given patient with the most appropriate technique represent a sophisticated exercise of clinical medicine which remains and will remain a balanced mixture of science and art. Future studies examining indication for dialysis initiation and outcome will contribute to evidence-based guidelines concerning the optimal timing for dialysis initiation. Thank you.
لو عندي كومبليكيشن بدأت تظهر، فمهم جدا وجود الكومبليكيشن simple when you let it be here. You wish on the status when I get the Abad Aruba, the Chief of Abad Aruba, Zema Kerr, and the Altan, and wish on the status of the Abad Aruba. أهم حاجة الروتيشن السيت الزمن لازم أنوكس كده هو اسمه في فارس 14 فيها سرعان ولكن لو كل في أربعة فهل ده ماشي مع ال مع الكلام بتاع سعد الله؟
طب حضرتك يعني أو جاز أسر جاب الأنسس يعني مش أوبجكت بس عايزين نتفق هذا بروجيست الموضوع مش أوبجكت ده في سبجكت إلمنت موجودة حاجة تانية بيتر ان احنا نعمل البريبريشن للبيشن ونوديه الاوبشنز المتعددة في القصة بتاعت الـ الانستيتيوت اللي احنا فيه
وهذا كلنا بنفكر في الدسكشن مع البيشن
الحاجة الثانية الحاجة الثانية مهمة جدا اتعلمناها من اساتذتنا هاو تو ديليفر باد نيوز از فيري فيري امبورتنت ممكن تقولها له كده انت تروح تحصل وخلاص ممكن تقولها بطريقة اخرى واخد بال ساعتها هي فيها ميكسشر في نفس الوقت انا هنا على عيان مش هسمح العيان ده يكبر حاجه تصلح بالغيرس دي الفكره برضه وات ايفر الارقام اللي جايه في ساعات بتبقى ميس ليدنج ريزلت موجوده انا قدام المريض بتاعي في داتا موجوده بتحكم معايا ولازم اكون واضح معاه وموضح له الرؤيه بتاعت الفيوتشر بتاعته النيوتريشن بتاعه مهم معاه ده جدا لان في بعض الناس تقول العيان ما تاكلش لحمه ما تاكلش كذا كذا عشان الكرياتين يقل ويديله انتصار خادع ان القصه اتحسنت والقصه بالعكس راح من
اسوء. ايه المقصود يا عزيزي؟ لاند ماس ان الكريم احنا هنشوف حاجه اخد بالك من سنايت اتش وانكروكس اغسل له الليد ولا ايه؟ كيرس بتاعه شيء ممكن يكشف بعد كلمه الليد دي يعني ليش تقول لي
شوف ساعات مش متفق مع ساعات في حاجات اوبجكتيف انا بتكلم على الارقام كرياتينين واحنا ما بنعتمدش على الكرياتين دلوقتي بنعتمد على الاستيميت سولار بريشر ريت وفي حاجات سبجكتيف مهمه جدا يعني انا عارف الرايتس ازاي هسيبه بيت العيان عنده بريزيستنت فوبت من الرايتس العيان بينص بيت في عيان طبعا بيبقى عارف السيمبتومز الناس دلوقتي بقى في اويرنس القصه بتاعت السيمبتوم بتاع كرونيك ديزيز عندك كذا لا ما عنديش عندك كذا ما عنديش لان انا في نفس الوقت بعمل اسسمنت انا بوصل العيان ده كل شويه فعند البيوس ويت على مدى فتره من شهر شهرين الراجل ده خس مثلا 5 6 ايام ده انديكيشن فور دايلسيس ده انديكيشن فور دايلسيس يعني اقصده مش كرياتين هو اللي يحركني مش معمل اللي يحركني ولازم الفرق بين النفرولوجي از دكتور وبيعمل ديسيجن وعارف الحاله بتاعته كويس وعارف ابعادها واي واحد تاني بره خريج برانش تاني زميل او حتى ايه في النيرس او ممكن نيرس شو كان 10 3 بس انت بقى لا قصه مش كده القصه فيها حاجات فيها اولويات فيها بنورك صعب في حاجات مرتبها واهم حاجه ان اقول العيان ده يخش القصه طيب
بس فكرني في احد المقاولات من زمان في اسكندريه من 10 سنين كان في سيشن كان حاضر فيها الدكتور عبد الجليل النحاس وكان في ذاك الوقت الكلام ايرن دانس ايرن دانس انا فاكر كان في سيشن ده كنت انا موجود مع الدكتور عبد الجليل كنت انا بغرد تماما خارج السيرفر لان هو كانت المحاضرات كلها ايرن انا فاكر في ذاك الوقت نط ويز ايرن
معلش هو فعلا احنا كنا في ميتنج في المنصوره في نقابه الاطباء الكلام التاهليه وكان كل الباريت لاينز مع الايرن دايلسس والوحيد اللي اتكلم قال لي يا جماعه مش مع الايرن دايلسس ده خالص انا مع الليد وفي عندي انديكيشن معينه والصاله هاجت وماجت ومن بعض الزملاء ازاي ده بس الباريت لاينز بتقول ان لازم نستارت ايرن دايلسس بعديها بقى بشهر او شهرين بقى تظهر البيبرز دي وبتظهر
كنت سعيد ان هو زي ما دلوقتي بيكون مش كرياتينين انا ما بعالجش كيميا اللي هو كرياتينين مقاولين بالذات ان في بعض العيانين تجد ان البروجريشن از فيري سلو يعني اي هاف بيشن مثلا الكرياتين بتاعه 8 كانوا سنه او سنتين فهنا الكرياتينين ممكن في بقى بقشر اعمل فيسترابات في بعض. انما الفنشيت لما الدكتور قال السيمبتوم بالذات اللي هي الريفرسال يعني ساعات ممكن عيان يبقى هناك جوز جاي بفومتنج مش قادر اعمل الهيموداياليس تهب الكرونيك الاول اتش اظبطها الاول انها بيرسيستنت كرونيتس بيرسيستنت فومتنج ويت لوس القصص دي اي هاف تو ستارت. شكرا دكتور طنطاوي.